Good morning, this is Doug.
And I'm Cindy.
Welcome to Help Me Help Mama Livecast. Thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be talking about leaving a legacy. You know, this is something that a lot of people, most people want to do, right?
Absolutely. You know, mom and dad worked hard their whole lives. They saved up some money. They bought a house. Maybe there's some land around it. They raised the kids in the house. They want to pass this along to their kids and grandkids.
You know, the problem is, for a lot of people, most of us have to have some sort of long-term care before we die.
You know,
at least a little bit.
Yeah, at least a little bit. And statistically, I mean, what is it, around 50%?
Yeah, close to 50%, yeah.
Long-term care. And long-term just means for a period of time. It can be in your home. It could be in an assisted living, an independent living, in a skilled nursing home. But it's long-term. And the thing is, most people don't plan for that.
You know, long-term care can be expensive even if it's at home. A lot of times people think, well, I'll just stay at home and it won't be expensive. But there's a lot of expenses even if you're at home.
You can get family members to help.
Hopefully. I mean, some people are fortunate enough to have local family that can help, at least some. And hopefully if there's a whole bunch of willing and able family members available, we've seen families actually pull that off, stay there at home, and family members chipping in, some of them more so than others sometimes, but you know, they can stay home for a long period of time. And if this is the case, they're able to pass on more many times to the family at their death because they didn't spend as much for their long-term care.
Right. But if you don't plan for this and there's a major health event and you need to enter skilled nursing, you're looking at about $7,000 a month.
Yeah, in our area of the country, I mean, some areas it's a little bit less, some areas it's easy double that.
Yeah.
You know, so it's expensive if you have to have skilled care or even assisted living care. So the point is to do everything you can if you do want to leave a legacy, to be able to pull us off and make it more likely that you will be able to leave a legacy. And if you're on our newsletter list, well, you probably got today's newsletter where we talk about leaving a legacy. If you're not, go to help.mom/cc and you can sign up for it. It's free. But in today's newsletter, we just give you a few tips for leaving a legacy. And the first one is professional consultation. You know, it's important to meet with like medical consultations, your physician, attorney, to check legal documents, your financial advisor. All of these are important. One key is to do it while you still have capacity to do it, because
absolutely,
when you don't have capacity, then
absolutely,
you can't do a lot of this good stuff.
You know, and a lot of this you can do by yourself for a while, but you may, and as many people do, get to the point where you can't handle things all by yourself. If you've got a good functional family, bring the family members in as soon as possible, because if I'm going to help my mom to stay at home and maintain a good quality of life, I'm going to need to schedule time for that. And your adult children are probably the same way. So bring them in early, sit down and talk about these things.
You know, another key is talk to mom. You know, that's kind of obvious, but a lot of people miss that point, don't they?
They do.
Mom, what would you like?
Yeah,
you
know? If you're the adult child, just sit down at the kitchen table with a cup of coffee and say, hey, mom, you know, had a friend that went through this with her parents and they lost their home. Dad was in the nursing home. Mom passed away. And, you know, it just turned out really bad. I want to help you. I want to know what you want. I want to help you attain your goals.
Yeah, and talk to family to see what they're willing and able to do. You know, like we said a few minutes ago, some people are fortunate enough, they've got several family members available that are willing and able to help. Some people, this is just not the case. But if there are a few family members and they can coordinate their schedule, and this one does this and this one does that, a lot of times they can prolong the amount of time that a senior can remain at home. And most people would, number one, would prefer to remain at home, and number two, would prefer that family help and not outside caregivers if that's possible, right?
Absolutely. But you know, it may come to the point where you do need outside caregivers, and that can be expensive. So it's best if you sit down with the family and come up with a plan, get as much family help as possible, and then look at the alternative of professional caregivers coming into the home to help make up time when family can't be there.
Once you've gathered all of the information, you know, mom's finances, where it's at, how she wants it spent.
What does she want?
And who's authorized to access money on her behalf, what legal documents she has, and get all of the information together. Well, then sit down with your family and have a mom-centered family meeting. The purpose of this is to get the best quality care for mom while maintaining balance in the adult kids' lives, you know. And in many families, that's possible for at least a longer period of time if everybody works together.
But it's got to coordinate with everybody's schedule, and that can be a challenge. So the sooner you start planning, the better results you're going to get.
Thank you for watching today. Again, if you haven't subscribed to our free newsletter, go to help.mom/cc and sign up for that. Remember also, we have a YouTube page and a Facebook page, and you can go to either one of these, join our Facebook, private Facebook page, or subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.
And thank you for being a caregiver for your loved one. You're making a huge difference in their life.